Hi everybody, here's Christian from TeamworkCast.
And this is Falko, hi.
And this is the April 27th Netrunner TeamworkCast Regionals North, German Regionals North in Osnabrück, Spieltraum, the Finale.
We see two Rainers, but one playing a Noise and the other playing HP. And that's the final game of the winner of the loser brackets, Frederick on the left, and Heinzel on the right, the winner.
Who's been doing pretty well this entire tournament. I played him once, and it was a fun game. Yeah. But yeah, he's been like on top table for this entire day, and he also went undefeated through the winner bracket. And of course, I wouldn't say the loser's bracket, it's the fun bracket.
It's a fun bracket. I didn't have fun in the fun bracket. Yeah, of course. But we see a restless leg syndrome on the right, yeah. And yeah. The man with the mass on his hands.
And a hat trick. And we see, so there's going to be HB on the left, the ability, and we have to maybe remind if there's some new players here. Frederick will get a credit the first time he installs a card.
Yes, he will.
And of course, on the right, we have Noise, and he will mill a card from top of R&D if he installs a virus.
So we have an installer in front of HQ, in front of R&D, two ices, and getting one money. Seven monies for the corp, not a good start for HP. The Noise gets a card.
Let's see about Noise.
Another card. Okay.
Heinzel has been showing like a very aggressive, very well-balanced Noise here. It's really a pleasure watching him play. Data Sucker, Milling, and then Aesops. We see Aesops. Pretty good start for Noise.
Yeah. When Aesops is there, Noise is heavy.
Yeah.
Aesops is on the moon, Noise will travel to the moon to sell him stuff.
Yeah, and of course Wildside is also on the moon. Everything cool is on the moon.
Not everything.
Yeah, what
come on,
what
the root is on the Earth.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Yeah, the root is the best thing.
I know, it's you love the root.
Yeah, and you know, we scorch you on the moon.
What?
We will scorch you on the moon.
Why? I don't get it. There's no air on the moon. Yeah. You cannot burn things if there's no air. Anyway, green level clearance, the card that has been making a comeback, you said?
Yeah. And Operation Money is always good for this kind of game. Mm. He doesn't use his opportunity to make a remote. He just ices up with Handwell. Archive ice is a good thing against Noise.
Yeah.
I don't know. I play another Noise than Heinzel. He plays a very, milling, mid-aggressive deck.
Yeah, he does mill a lot, but he also is, stays aggressive at the same time. So Noise players, pay attention here and right now. We see a run on HQ, and there is the Victor 2.0.
Two clicks for just shutting off a subroutine, accessing one card, and it's a Jackson and he doesn't have the money.
That's a very, very painful thing to encounter on those runs.
As a Noise, you want to trash the Jackson.
God, the yellow man has to go, but not this time. That's what we say to the God of Death.
Victor 2.0 is a great eyes with Order and Chaos. He has a little bit of a slowdown because Spoon is there. A drop of another Adonis. Aesops, I think.
Aesop, but this time it's Alt Arts. Is that a strategy, do you think?
No, I don't think.
He just doesn't have enough?
Yeah. I think so. Okay, that's blue level clearance. We're getting one step ahead. Two clicks for three monies and two cards. So it's a little bit of speed getting through your deck and just setting up. Frederick does it, perfect, I have to say.
Oh, he's very steady as she goes. And trashing one card.
And perhaps we have to remind our viewers of a sexy leg in on the top left.
If you want to get on those, I think that's Yaro, actually. Yeah, it's Yaro. Okay. I recognize him on the shorts.
Hey, David, dropping the David, spending two counters.
Spending two David counters to get through her so he can pawn Aesop's Pawnshot later on. That's that's a good idea, probably.
Yeah.
And then accessing a card, and that is the
Restructure.
Or Restructure.
He would have loved to have an imp.
Yeah, an imp would be really great.
Mm-hmm. Two clicks left. What does Noise do?
The question is, will you trash the
run on Andy?
Oh, nice.
just keeping him low. Oh.
That is just the silver. But that's great. That's
perfect for Parasite.
That's what I want to say. That's why you want to rest stuff with the noise so we can have targets for your Parasites. And that is a great target for a Parasite.
And getting one money.
Just as well have like a, you know, Parasite-shaped outline. They put your Parasite here, please.
Mandatory draw from Frederick. He thinks about stuff. He has now a board presence with one breaker that gets through R&D, through HQ, and a data sucker. And noise can explode in one turn, so he has to be very, very secure.
So we see in style, there's a decision coming up for Heinzel. Will you pawn shop that David with one token still left?
Yes, of course. He's on one money. He has to. He has to get to four monies and, ask him about stuff.
What was installed where? So, yeah, Frederick sees the vulnerability here and decides to ice up the R&Ds even more.
And Aesop's buys a lot of stuff and the David is three monies for him. So, on four monies at the start of your turn, you have four clicks and two data suckers. What do you do? Drawing for a Parasite? No, running the remote. I like Heinz's stuff.
All of the things. Yeah.
Very good.
Yeah, staying aggressive here. If there's no cards coming up that he needs, then at least can maybe make the opponent struggle a little bit. And with four credits, he can trash a potential Adonis there. Oh. So yes, we see a res.
Another next dice. Now on strength 2, because two next dice are a res. And next bronze has a strength of the rest next dice. One and the run subroutine. And the Parasite is there. And the run is there.
And then running again. And now with the Data Sucker token can be killed very easily.
He has to pay two. Oh, that's narrow.
I think there's a Falko interjecting here. Yes!
Falko interjecting!
Beautiful!
Successful.
Beautiful!
We have
to say
to our listeners,
you can't drive, but you still can netrunner.
Of course, I can count. I was a judge on the tournament. The TO was Oliver, and at the final tables, I just was standing there and looking at the table and saying, you're doing stuff wrong.
Yes. So that's a really interesting, like, that was kind of like a Pyrrhic victory for Heinzel here. He was able to trash this ice with a Parasite, but then he didn't have the money anymore to trash the Adonis campaign. Sad face.
But an ice is gone. And Noise has to trash something, and if he trashes with his Virus Miles other ice, the Corp is in a very bad spot. So
we
it's
see
a
green
thing.
Level clearance here for Frederick. Trying to stay up here.
And yeah, the Adonis will get rest if he has another ice. Now it's just another remote. Yeah. Oh, and there's in store getting one money for it. And keeping Heinzel on his back feet. Very good. The Data Sucker goes for three monies. Good idea. That has to go. You have to get the money for the show gamble. If you do a show gamble and didn't send the Data Sucker, you're biting yourself in the ass.
That's something I really like. At some point, I will play a bit of noise, and that's something I am constantly shocked by when I see those noise players just trashing all the things that seem so useful to me.
You have deja vu.
You
get it back.
Indeed,
and that's Earthrise Hotel, the best card out of Lunar Cycle. After that, Frederick rezzes the Adonis, behind his unrest eyes, getting some money off it back, and that's a good move. Just keeping. Yeah, the pressure on the runner.
Heinzel concedes the initiative here because he invested a lot of money to get this Earthrise Hotel out. He clearly needs some more cards. I'm thinking he's looking for a cash right now.
I think so too.
Alright, so we see a card installed, an upgrade installed in that server, and we see a imp being installed.
That was wrongly. Perfect. Okay. An imp. The best card for noise in the moment. Accessing HQ and trashing the restructure. Just don't get the money for HP. We have Adonis running. We have an upgrade installed in the remote and the ice.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it doesn't get rest because he. What does he do? He just looks at the cards and making clear of the board state. That's the thing Frederick does all the time. He just, every time he looks at his cards, makes it clear what does he have, where, and he's a very analytic player.
Yes, he is. And that's really amazing. Like, especially if you lose against him, you kind of feel like as if he like was always like two or three steps ahead. He kind of planned everything ahead. It's kind of like, can be very, very intimidating.
I had a little bit of time after playing Frederick in the Swiss rounds. So we just exchanged the decks and he beat me with my decks. It was crazy. Yeah. He's just a good player.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, so the Alfred Sattel doing a good stuff for Heinzel right now. He runs on the archives. He wants to see the cards that he all milled, and ooh, that is the rotor turret. Oh, I don't hate you.
Yeah, no clone chip out, so the rotor turret does as it works.
Really and good right now, really yeah. good.
Mm. What would you do? You don't have expectations, you're just standing there as a runner, have your economy a little bit up, but the HP is setting up all his remotes.
It's also kind of hilarious that, you know, rotor turret, especially against noise, is really bad because you can be parasites so easy, but now this rotor turret does so much good stuff, like getting rid of this imp, denying the Ace of Pawn Shop trash.
Yeah.
But of course, I think we're going to see the Ace of Pawn Shop being used for the Athras Hotel now, right?
Yeah, of course. Mm-hmm. You have to have money.
Mm-hmm.
So with the last counter on it, you have four cards for four monies and getting three monies back. That's one action and one credit for four cards. Mm-hmm. That's great.
And we see Frederick really stabilizing here with the Adonis campaign.
Mm-hmm.
Getting all this money up. Checking all the ice.
Yeah. He has to be sure.
Where did I put my car keys?
I don't think Frodo can drive already.
I don't think so too. Yeah, he's a minor.
He's very,
right?
Yeah, I think so.
All right, so we see the hedge fund being used.
But very great that both players just keep the money open and organized. And they loved you, not like Niels. The big asshole in the German community.
But it doesn't matter anyway, because through our successful Patreon campaign, you now, our listeners, you can see those beautiful credit counters that I will be displaying.
Ooh, wow. Oh, no, he doesn't sell it to Aesops. He just used it for two cards.
Oh, he really wants the card draw. I mean, he's looking for the cash, I think. Wow, look at,
through the stack.
You know that frustration as well as I do, where it's like you just drawing, I want to see this card, I'm losing the game, but draw, discard 8.
And come on, installing a card with recurring credits without using the recurring credit? I hate it.
As
a last click, he installed the Cyber Cipher with a recurring credit. But he can't use it in this turn, so...
He has to drop it. I mean, he has to discard all the things, and clearly this is the only thing that he can actually install with so few credits.
But we don't have two absence here.
Heinzel is really doing bad, I think. Like, I think he's kind of like frustrated by this, and I can understand. Like, I think he's looking for a cash. He's looking for some kind of way to get back economically, and he's just not seeing the cards he wants to see.
Yeah, but he could have run on the remote, on other stuff.
That didn't work so well last time, did it?
Yeah, but that's a hard move now. With one money, there's a scoring remote with an upgrade and a two-at-once card. What do you do?
Yeah.
You can't
do
anything.
At least now he can like scavenge the thing.
He has to, no. Ooh, I would have sold the Cyber Cypher. No,
he
draws, that's crazy.
Drawing. All right, injecting. Come on, man. Gotta see that cash. Oh, there's the cash.
Yeah, going to the bin.
Yeah. And but he gets some credits. Now we're gonna see a cash recur with the last click.
I hope so. Yeah, with the last click. What do you do?
Not cool.
Not indeed. Deja vu is for an ass.
All right.
Come on, Heinzel.
Well, next turn is gonna be like a really cool cash turn.
He has now installed two beautiful feeders, not using recurring credits at all.
What do you think? Is that a
3-2?
3-2.
Mm-hmm. I think so.
No, or I would say an APD.
Okay. If he had nothing else, he would have installed an NFPD, of course. No, it's a 5-3.
It's an APD.
Wow, you're right. Well, bam. I bow my head to you.
Bam.
And I just point stuff out. Please put this agenda over there.
That's good.
Just keeping stuff organized. And another install.
Keeping
the pressure. Yeah, come on. It could be nothing, but he has to look. Deja vu on cache and... Parasite, okay.
Parasite, that's good. Yeah. So now with third click, he can now install the cache. Yes!
For +3 monies.
Yeah.
And a mil, of course. And the fourth click could be a Parasite.
No.
Grimoire. Oh, okay. On 0 money, but getting 3 from Aesop's next turn because selling this cash.
Well, Heinzel has a lot of catching up to do right now. And so this is also like really like a huge scoring window for Frederick.
He's on 2 agenda points, 2 Iron Way agenda points, I would say.
Oh, man. Accelerated beta test score. Sneaky, sneaky.
Yeah.
He saw that what Heinzel was doing, he assumed that there would be no run.
Would you assume that the ABT was on hand as he installs an APD and then advance it 2 times?
Yeah, usually that's what I see a lot of HB players with these kinds of steps doing, like where they first put an APD, APD out to kind of scout if the runner really has like a scoring window here or if he is kind of like holding back some kind of like mean attack.
So it's kind of like, or something else.
Yeah, or like inside job or something, you know.
Yeah,
could be. And if there's nothing coming up and you can like easily score the APD, then you can follow up with an actual score. If they scored an APD, then you will actually have the scoring window for the agenda you want to score.
And we have to keep people in mind, watchers in mind, that Frederick is on the edge because he has to win this game.
Yes,
and then he has to win another game.
Yeah.
If he does win this game.
Parasite, the Tolbooth.
Okay. So.
And a clone ship. Oh, yeah. Finally, the deck of Heinzel is starting to work.
Okay. I would have run Archives with the Dust. Just getting some money off the co-op.
I think now he can recur a Parasite next turn. That's a good
deal. No. Architect is there. So the last turn run on Arcas is not that
good. Yeah, it's not really good.
Okay, I take it back.
Probably not a good idea.
If there's an agenda he run last turn, that would be bad.
That would be very, very bad.
Is very, very frustrated.
He is. He's face palming.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. There is a hedge fund.
What would you have done differently to Heinzel?
I don't know. I'm not a very experienced noise player, but I think he was really screwed by the card draws that he just had.
The scoring modes gets another install and an advance. Wow. Mm.
All right. So
at the end
of the clone ship is used for a cache, I would assume, right? Or what?
I think so too.
Yeah.
And you get another mill. You get 3 money, 4 monies from this. Mm-hmm. Because Grimoire's out, and then you sell it, so you have 7.
Mm, very, very nice.
Yeah. But now he has to get into Arcas.
Yep. How are you going to do that, Heinzel?
A Mimic and David.
We have to assume there is no Jackson out, so if there is a Jenna that have been milled, this is going to be great.
I would run on the remote.
All right, inject. Inject. He has mass installed here. Mm. All of these cards, none of these are programs.
Yeah, get all on hand. Mm-hmm. So what do you do? Heinzel, show us.
What do you do indeed?
And you told us that if YouTube just gets a sniff of copyrighted music, it will be banned. So yes. If I sing another good song.
No, because you sing so horribly, YouTube will never recognize it. Maybe it will get matched with kind of, I don't know, some kind of pig video somewhere, you know.
You're such an asshole.
Or some kind of yodeler, I don't know.
But we have to get back to the game, 4-0 for the corp.
Oh, yeah, that is the deja vu, getting back the cash, recurring the cash, and getting the Crypsis. There will be runs, ladies and gentlemen, there will be runs. So,
getting 4 monies from the cash.
Yeah.
Andermill. What does he do?
Will he install the Critters now? Oh, no. Ooh, Earthrise. Oh, another Earthrise.
He sets up for a long game, but it could be over in just three turns.
It could be over very soon, indeed. We see probably we're going to see another score.
Let's see what Frederick does. Hardcore player, just milling cards. Perhaps he has a Jackson on hand and will install it now.
Nope. Score. NAPD.
Ooh, 6 points. Wow.
I now really want to see that ice that he scores behind.
Is Quick already out?
Which one?
Quick.
Quicksand, you mean?
Nay, Quick.
No, Crick is not out yet. The legal set is the Valley. I think Crick didn't have the Valley. The Valley didn't have the Crick.
Nope.
I think that was the next one, which was.
So with Crypsis, he could just run Arcas.
Break a bay.
And that's Crypsis. Wait a moment.
Yep.
Hi.
So yeah, Crypsis being installed has one token on there due to the Grimoire.
Yeah.
We have to assume that. We have to gonna see it run on archives. There ought to be some agendas there.
It should be. Because they have no asset in the remote. That's the best chain. Perhaps milling two cards.
But he doesn't have really a lot of credits. Oh. He gets a credit.
Okay.
Okay.
The caches are still in his stack. That's not good.
Oh man.
And third click.
Struggling, so much struggle. Getting another credit, and last is run on archives, I assume, right?
Heinzel, we're feeling with you.
Oh man,
that's
this is really
not a good noise.
Like, that's really bad against HB, because it's do you get the credits to be able to break better things, or do you save the clicks, because there might be a Bioroid that you have to click through.
A fucking HB. Great play.
A really amazing placement here right now. This is so difficult to break.
Because if Heinzel had won on the first click,
he would have Heinzel hadn't gotten those two credits, it would have been so much easier. Now it's so difficult.
Crazy.
And he lets everything fire. He just lets it go. I mean, trash the Crypsis gets trashed, and there is a trace.
Frederick, just looking through the stack of the runner.
Yeah, like Frederick checks the discard pile, not sure why. Oh yeah, he's thinking about what the trace is going to be. And Heinzel also checks his discard pile. Why is he checking my discard pile?
I don't know. But it's a very tense game. Yeah. Their boss playing the best of their ability after, I think, 10 hours of Netrunner. Or not?
Oh yeah. This is a tough one. This is important. Like, if Heinzel wins, he wins this tournament.
Yeah.
And what a run he had. And I think this is like the first time he really faces like a huge uphill battle. All right, this is going to be a trace 9, ladies and gentlemen. 9.
Okay.
It's the last click, so there's going to be no way for Heinzel to remove this tag.
So Frederick is setting up for a long game because he wants to trash the Aesop. Nothing else comes into my mind.
This is going to be 9. He's Frederick will have 4 credits left.
Yeah. Trashing Aesop, trashing Earthrise.
9 also means that Heinzel cannot battle this trace.
Yeah, gets a brain damage from the itchy and attack. And gets access.
And we see 1 agenda.
2 points.
Oh, man. Ooh, after all those mills, just 1 agenda. That is painful, of course. That is very, very painful. He was hoping for more here.
Noise can win against everything and can lose against anything.
So he lost so much on this run. He got a tag. He lost the Crypsis. He got a brain damage. And, of course, now I think he will be losing his Ace of Spawn Shop.
Mandatory duel. What does Frederick do now? That's an install.
He's using install and hedge fund and then trashing the Aesop's command shop. Man, what a beautiful answer turn. Planned this turn perfectly while thinking about how to increase the trace. Just a perfect, like, getting the credit from the install, being able to play the hedge fund afterwards and having the credits to trash. So he's up on the monies again, and he really created like a huge problem for Heinzel to deal with right now.
That's just showing the level of play we both won't get to.
Yeah, this is just insane. This was, and you like as a normal runner, where it's like, yeah, we're playing on some GNK tournaments, and you're looking at this like, why are they like obsessing about this one trace, you know? Yeah. But this one trace might have been decided, you know, the rest of this entire game.
Okay, run on the remote.
Yes. So finally, Heinzel is like just down to the wire. He's just checking everything.
Seven monies on the cops turn. And we see that both Aesop's pawn shop are in the bin.
Mm-hmm.
That was perhaps the thing Frederick was looking for.
That could very well be.
Yeah.
And there's an ash being rest.
Okay. Nothing else. Just the ash.
Just the ash.
Trash a dash.
Yeah.
Come on, trash a dash.
This is crazy. If this is like some Bayreuth in front and Heinzel will run the second time around. He takes it back. Take back.
Okay. Take back from Frederick. Mm-hmm. That's rare. Ah, okay.
All right. So he decides not to res it and he lacks just Heinzel axes both.
Wrong.
Well, the question for Heinzel, like, what do you do with this? Like, none of these get me closer to my victory.
Yeah, but okay, he decided to not trash that ash because
He already proceeded to the next card. Yeah.
Yeah.
So no trash, nothing. Both.
Wow. Mm. Okay. So Heinzel has another plan in his head.
I guess. Hopefully.
Yeah.
All right.
What?
That plan involves a cyber feeder. And then getting out the imp.
Also, you know, on my side, the third cyber feeder is just obsolete, in my opinion.
Again.
Come on
the
dark side.
Counting here. Again.
Come on.
I'm coming on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was not a good play. No Aesops. He can't send the cyber feeder.
No Aesops. No money.
Not a great place.
No so, flower.
Oh, okay. Getting back the economy?
Yes.
Yeah. Hedgehog.
Hedgehog. Baby.
And hedgehog.
Ooh.
Yeah. So.
Yeah, like Frederick, I mean, we can say a lot about how things are going bad for Heinzel.
Yeah, but
Frederick is also down on the money.
That's another singular signal for Heinzel. Oh, I will use now the scoring remote for something else. And that's pressure.
Yeah.
Great play.
Under pressure. All right. So there's a lot of...
You do want to get on the YouTube ban list, yeah?
Oh, man.
Re-level for two monies and one card.
That's a good... Man, he has so many economy cards in this deck. This deck is just all economy and all
two actions plus six monies and one card. Wow.
Wow, yeah. And wow, indeed.
Checking another time the stack of a runner.
Yeah, this is getting really close now. So, you know, I think that Frederick is really excited now because it looks like he might be able to take this game home. And that would mean he has a chance for the win.
Yeah, but Frederick doesn't get excited.
No. Well, I don't know. He's a human being.
No, he isn't.
No, he's a robot.
No, he's a robot. That's a sex robot.
He's a silent.
No, he's Adonis.
Adonis himself.
No, there's a trilogy from FFG books. Mm-hmm.
I played
Parasite Killing the Ice sweet. In front of Andy. And Golem is called the Triology. And there's a Byrides that's a detective. And that's Frederick.
All right. I gotta read about Frederick in a next Kindle download.
And the run on Andy? Or not? Yeah.
And with a clone chip?
Perhaps.
That's good.
Oh, Architect. Fuck, yeah.
And yeah, that's going to be a trouble.
There's no Mimic in the stack of...
What are we going to do now? This is just so bad. He doesn't play a Mimic, right?
And you see this level of play. It's like fast, until it gets to the edge.
Yeah,
and they are looking for every decision. Wow.
Yeah, that Architect will fire, man.
Oh, God.
There's just, like, no way. Like, he could maybe get the Crypsis, but then that's going to be everything he does.
Yeah, indeed. And he has to install in the scoring remote.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Oh, man. This is not something I want to see.
Heinzel, I'm sorry. He could now use the clone ship to get a virus.
Another card.
From hand. He from could hand. Use now the clone ship to get a virus to mill a card in front before the access.
Yeah, so he can get to see a card that he would otherwise not see.
Yeah. He could
will
use
he do that?
It for the medium.
Because we have to assume that Frederick saw the cards on top, yeah. And he knows that there is no agenda on top. He lets. So now, so now that's what Heisel does. Now he gets out the medium.
Medium, as I said.
And then trashes top card, and we'll see two cards now. Sweet. So that was a good choice after all.
Of course.
Oh, and then Jackson being used. Oh, so there was an agenda there.
Wow.
Oh, man.
Wow.
Oh. Plot twists within plot twists.
I think in this moment, everyone on the table is flipping out.
I was watching myself and I saw the agendas that he had there. I was like, what? What? I'm just blown. My mind is blown. Oh.
The best thing would be to leave the agendas now in archives.
If there's agendas in archives, you don't know.
Yeah. Could be. Because he has the scoring agenda in his remote. Ah, oh, crazy game.
Crazy,
cutting
crazy.
The game, two cards. It could be the win because Frederick plays 5-3s. No agenda.
That's the blue level
so it's over.
I think. Yeah, in pink it.
That's a trash.
You think so? Do you think that's an agenda there?
No.
Immune agenda and scoring survey, I mean.
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, let's see.
Come on.
That. Cash.
Just cash for trash, and he shows
and
the agenda.
Perfect. Sweet.
Wow.
Well done, gentlemen. Well done. What an exciting game.
Wow,
especially
that
finale, man. That was just amazing. I wish we could have seen the cards that Frederick saw on that last access. That was a pretty exciting.
Your next goal on the Patreon campaign would be getting two cameras.
Yeah, like so additional little cameras everywhere. Yeah, yeah. Like or maybe
great.
Like a glass table I bring with me so you can see what cards are installed.
But the mats. That do want to play on mats. So you have to have an eagle eye camera and two cameras on the back of the players.
We have to invent mats which are transparent.
From one side.
Mm-hmm. But not from the
other. Yeah.
I mean, that kind of technology has so many different applications as well. Man.
Yeah.
Clothing
for women.
Yeah, I didn't want to go there, but thanks. thanks for giving like this chauvinistic edge to this to this little show that we try to keep family friendly.
I'm here.
All right, Falko. One last word about your podcast show that you're doing.
I'm doing a German podcast, Meta Arena, and an English podcast called The Fifth Stick, where I want to spend time on air with people spending their fifth stick for Netrunner, just investing time they don't have for their family.
Yes.
And that's a great thing, like you do.
Yes, I do. So check out this amazing show. I mean, it's you have a German podcast, but this one is kind of like for English people, and it is a good way to get a look into the meta on the people that are working on a Netrunner or making a Netrunner a happy place. And of course, we also have a Patreon campaign for this show that you're watching right now, which is on patreon.com/ Hack the
Planet!
Hyped up planet!
Stop and get in the car!
Shit on me.